Hey everyone, today I'm going to show you a new tool to be able to capture steps and create a quick documentation about those steps. I do this all the time. I basically create step-by-step products or FAQs that somebody can go through on how to use applications. So this feature inside of SnagIt is tremendously helpful and it's quick and easy to be able to do. I don't even need to drag out my screen or anything like that. It'll capture all the steps as I'm working through them. So I'm going to go ahead and pull up the sample webpage. I use this for my Camtasia certification. You can check out the certification there, where you can go through everything Camtasia and get certified by TechSmith themselves. But I use this website to be able to go in and just practice creating screen recordings. So I'm going to use this to capture steps and exactly what I do inside of this application. So I have the latest SnagIt pulled up, and if I click on this here, it is under selection here, and it is a new option. Instead of region or full screen, I can go ahead and do steps. Now, I want to make sure that I capture my cursor because I want to be able to show people exactly where the cursor is pointing, and it will highlight and call out things as I'm capturing it as well. But if I go ahead and click on capture, it's going to say capturing steps, click button, stop button to stop, and my stop button is down at the bottom here, and it will tell me how many steps are being captured. Now we just need to do whatever we need to do here. So this is the first one is requesting, if you see this, is requesting help. Yep, SnagIt helper. Let's go ahead and just allow it. And then I'm going to go ahead and click on, and I had to like click on the screen and do some stuff. So if you need to restart the steps, you can just click on restart and it will restart from the very beginning. If alerts or something like that pop up, you may need to do that. All right, so now I'm at the beginning. I can just go ahead and click on my webpage and then I can click on products. Then I can go to list, and then I just click on the item that I want to talk about, and then I just click somewhere else down here, and then type in something, and then click somewhere off of that, and then I'll click save up on the top. So I just went through an entire process, and once I'm done, I just come down to the bottom left-hand side, and I can pause it if I need to. I'm going to go ahead and click on stop here. Now what it will do is it will pull up your editor, your SnagIt editor here, and it will create an entire process documentation. So you can see right here, it is capturing my Safari. Obviously, we'd want to change this to something else, how to update a product or whatever the process is. Any text that you see, you can go ahead and update that text. Now I can take this, and if I click on these little three dots for each of the sections, I can go ahead and duplicate it. I can move it up, I can move it down. Duplicating is if I wanted to talk a little bit more about it, or if I wanted to call something else about it out, because you can come in and just like any other type of SnagIt application, you can add other shapes, you can add other highlights as well. But it captured and zoomed in, so it already zoomed in on those different parts, wherever I clicked, essentially. So you can see that it does have this little click here, and you can see that I clicked on products, and this was the very first one. And the very first one, let me go ahead and close that. I was just trying to click the page to start capturing, so I can go ahead and delete that one. So the very first thing is I'd want to say, click on products. So up on the top, it automatically captured what that name was. I can update the text if I wanted to explain it a little bit more. Click on list as well. And so it just basically captures whatever name of the button it is. So click here. That's not really specifying much. So click inside of the text field. And make your updates. Now, if it zoomed in on a certain spot that I don't like, what I could do is I can actually zoom out on various parts, or I can adjust the crop if I wanted to. So if you double click to go into the image, you can then adjust the crop. It originally captured the entire screen, so that's why I have things to work with, and I can move the crop to wherever I want. So let's center that right here. And then just click off that. You can see that we can also move the highlight to specify where we wanted them to click. Tremendously helpful for me to be able to create a process documentation, go through the process that I want to capture, comment and notate everything I want the learner to know on each step. Well, then I can come up to top here and I can actually export this as a PowerPoint if I wanted to. I can export this as a keynote and various different things. So if I go into file and then I go down to export, I can do batch export. And then this is where I can then select this drop-down box to be PDFs. And then I can choose exactly where I want this as well. So you can export it out, share it as a PDF, and then basically have this process that you can come in and update this inside of SnagIt. If you keep it in your editor, you can update it at any time. Hopefully this has been helpful for you and saved you a little bit of time in the future to be able to create process documentation a lot quicker. If you want to check out more, you can head on over to my website. I have a lot of apps that you can check out, various different tasks, checklist apps. You can also check out my GSAP animation studio tool. You can also check out full courses covering everything from the A to Z in Storyline, JavaScript and Storyline, XAPI fundamentals, Articulate Rise, Custom Scorm. You can also go ahead and check out all of my previous blog posts. I post a video a week. And then also templates, you can download those and use those as well. If you like this video, head on over to my YouTube channel, click the like button, subscribe to my channel, as well as hit the bell notification so you get notified of all future videos as they come out. That really helps my channel, allows me to continue to grow, allows me to continue to create these videos for you and reach more learning developers to give them tips and tricks to become better learning developers as well. That is the goal of this channel. That's all I have for today. So thanks everyone, and I'll see you next time.